Hello, friends. This short video serves as an addition to my video tutorial on Home Assistant, Initial Settings, File Editor, MariaDB, HCS, which I filmed in October 2023, with the link in the video description. The tutorial remains relevant as of the date of this video, except for one aspect, the addition of system monitor platform sensors designed to monitor the hardware state of the server. Therefore, I decided not to reshoot the entire lesson, but to make just a small addition. The essence of the change is that some time ago, these sensors were added to the graphical interface, and the manual addition method I showed earlier no longer works. How to do it now, see further in my mini tutorial. Before we start, as per tradition, I ask you to like this video, as it helps promote it on YouTube, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so before. Just in case, I remind you that the actions shown in this video are relevant for all Home Assistant installation options, as they concern the setup of the standard integration. Specifically, on this server, Supervised Home Assistant, installed on Linux Debian 12, shown in my previous video. I performed some actions shown in the Home Assistant tutorial, Initial Settings, in particular, installed the File Editor add-in. With its help, I specified the path to the packages and the configuration, admittedly reducing the depth of folder nesting, but this is inconsequential, and added a button on the left panel to call the system window. This is what it looks like. It contains information about kernel versions, supervisor, system, Docker, and has buttons for restarting services and rebooting the system, as well as a system log. All these actions are shown in the tutorial and are relevant today. And here's the part related to system sensors. It's outdated. The tutorial showed a manual addition method that was current at that time. We wrote several sensors in one of the packages to monitor the hardware part of the server. But a few months after that tutorial was released, the platform was moved to the graphical interface. For those who already had sensors specified, the transfer was automatic, and the entries had to be deleted or commented out. In new installations, you now need to specify them through the integrations menu, which is located in the Settings tab. Click on the Add Integration button at the bottom right, and in the window that appears, search for System Monitor by name. Here, click on Submit to start the integration setup. Then, Finish, and with that, the addition process is completed. The new integration appears on the panel. Let's see what's in it. As we can see, there are a total of 88 system parameters that can be monitored. This number may vary, depending on your specific configuration, and can reach several hundred objects. But by default, they are all disabled. There are no sensors in the integration. Click on this line to open the list of available objects. Most of the sensors do not have a practical application. For example, the IP addresses of all network interfaces, including the internal Docker network. I see no particular reason to monitor specific folders on the disk. It's sufficient to monitor only the root folder. To add a sensor to the system, for example, CPU usage, you need to find it in the list and click on it. Then press the Settings button in the top right corner. And activate the toggle switch to enable this object. After that, press the Update button. A message will appear saying that the object will appear in the system within 30 seconds. In the same way, turn on all the other necessary sensors. I added a total of 9 sensors. CPU usage and temperature, memory and disk usage in percentages and megabytes, as well as their free volume and time since the last boot. Add them to the dashboard. This is adding in manual dashboard control mode. In automatic mode, they will appear by themselves. If you have YAML mode enabled, you need to manually write the code. Done, the sensors have been added to the system and are displayed in the interface. The other steps shown in the first settings tutorial, as well as in subsequent tutorials, are still relevant and do not need updating at this time. That's all. I hope this video was useful to you and that everything worked out. If you have any questions, write them in the comments. I would appreciate your likes. They will help other users interested in the smart home topic find this lesson. In the video description, you will find links to videos on this topic, my Telegram channel, Facebook page, and a discussion group on smart home issues. Join us. It will be interesting. Thank you for your attention. Until next time, peace to everyone.